If you opened our world like a dollhouse, America would be split down the center, heart wide open, bleeding, grieving. Wednesday, a gunman opened fire in Parkland, Florida, setting Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in smoke, killing 17. Fire alarms drew kids outside. A 19-year-old former student expelled for being undisciplined opened fire far and wide. Trump said no child or teacher should ever feel unsafe in school, but seems to run and hide when it comes to gun control. Massachusetts has the toughest gun laws countrywide, and 2 people per 100,000 die. In Florida, the number goes up to almost 13. Who makes our laws and what do we prioritize? If you opened our world up like a dollhouse, America will be split down the center. In the right wing lies a stuffy office, where the president pretends Russia isn't dwelling down the hall, delivering papers dipped in propaganda for the 2018 midterm election. In the left wing stands a dining room, where groundbreaking portraits of the Obamas invite us to come in and admire. Michelle poised in exquisite elegance, gray tones among the blue, Barack adorned in lush leaves and trees, and nature runs its course, and we do too. But despite chaos and contradiction, this February, everyone travels to the living room, Pyeongchang, gathering to watch the Olympics, and long-loathed enemies like North and South Korea unite, if only for a fortnight. Posters are plastered on bedroom walls, on mine, 17-year-old Chloe Kim hangs with pride, first-generation Asian American bringing home the gold. So if you fold up our world up like a dollhouse, you see, like every family, we have our cracks and breaks. So we will work to clean our attics and basements, organize our communities, organize our country, help every priority, law, and joy find its place.